go. And we'll begin by turning things over to Alex Vallejo, who will take the requisite step to formally open our meeting. I note that Todd Sherman, representing Mr. Robert Mojica, Director of the Division of the Budget, is participating in the meeting by video conference from the New York State Division of Budget Conference Center at the Capitol Building, room 131 in Albany. And Stephen Weiss from the agency's Buffalo Regional Office at Electric Tower, 535 Washington Street, Suite 105, and Marge Rogatz from Champion Office, Suite 1225, Franklin Avenue, Suite 325, Garden City, New York. I will ask for motions and seconds to call to order the December 15th, 2016 Audit Committee meetings of the New York State Housing Finance Agency, the New York State Affordable Housing Corporation, the State of New York Mortgage Agency, the State of New York Municipal Bond Bank Agency, and the Tobacco Settlement Financing Corporation. May I have motions for HFA and AHC, AHC and seconds?
So moved.
Second.
Motion for Sunny May and a second?
So moved.
Marge, second?
Okay.
Mike Harrison, just a second.
All right. Motion for MBBA and TSFC and a second?
So moved.
Second.
As items are presented to each committee today throughout today's meetings, these motions and seconds will be used unless specific items call for a different vote, or unless any committee member or director wishes to record his or her vote differently.
Okay. I just want to, who else is at the, in the DOB? Is Linda Baldwin there? Anyone else in Albany?
Hi, I'm here. Sorry, I was on mute. And there was the representative from Budget was here.
Great.
But he just stepped out for a quick second, but he'll be back.
Okay. All right, I note that Chairman Thompson is the agency's chair and will chair the Audit Committee meetings for MBBA, TSFC, and Sunny May. Nestor Davidson is the Audit Committee chair for HFA and AHC, and he will chair those meetings for purposes of convenience and to make sure the meetings of the respective agencies go smoothly. Items chaired by one or more of the agencies will be presented by Mr. Davidson. The following minutes shall be deemed approved absent corrections from the members of directors: the 61st HFA audit meeting held on 9/15/2016, the 56th AHC audit meeting held on the same date, the Sunny May audit meeting held on that date, the 48th MBBA audit committee meeting held on 9/15/2016, and the 47th TSFC meeting held on that date.
We will now move to shared action items. Item 2, resolution approving audit committee action plan for 2017. Gary?
Good morning.
Morning.
On an annual basis, we present the action plan for the next year. Just reviewing some of the items that we went over in the previous year, we had the usual approvals of financial statements. We had a couple of training sessions. One of them was on audit committee responsibilities that I presented last April with Janet Oberstein, the internal control officer. And the we had a presentation by Ernst & Young on reading financial statements and then on using HFA as an example in June. We went over the usual stuff, the internal audit work plan, internal audit reports throughout the year. During the next year, I presented a calendar, which is similar to the prior year. One of the things that I made sure to put in was the bank examiners had suggested that the audit committee review accounting policy. So in April, and they're responsible for Sunny May. That's the only one they review. So in April, we're going to present some accounting policy matters that particularly concern Sunny May. Next month, in the January meeting, we're going to be presenting a survey, as we do every year, asking the committee members how they felt the responsibilities were being met, and asking for any suggestions for any other items that we could be going over to address your concerns for education needs.
It looks terrific.
Thanks.
Now before all five committees is a resolution of the audit committees approving an action plan for the period from January 1, 2017 through December 31, 2017. Assuming the first and seconds previously entered for all five committees, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Motions are carried. The resolution adopted.
We move to item 3, resolution reviewing and approving the internal audit staff functions.
Once again, we're going to ask you to approve the internal audit staff function. In accordance with the audit committee's charter, each year the committee must approve and review the internal audit function. The document you have in front of you is similar to the one you've seen in the past, but it's been brought current. I'll go through it briefly. The first paragraph pretty much talks about the committee's responsibility to review and approve the audit group's purpose and authority, its audit plan, staffing, its budget, and to review internal and external audit reports. The second paragraph talks about the group's responsibility to develop and maintain an effective internal audit program and to ensure that internal controls are in place. It goes on to talk about the audit plan that covers the period of April 1st, 2016 to March 31st, 2017, which was approved by the committee on April 9th. It also mentions the quarterly status reports that are sent, as well as that all reports and management responses are presented to the audit committee. Next paragraph just gives a little background on the staffing. And by the way, we've added an additional person since last year. And also it gives a bit of my background, career with the agency, compensation, and other responsibilities. So once again, we're going to ask you to approve the internal audit function.
Just the only question I have is, it's great to see we've added someone. Do you feel like the staffing levels are adequate now, given the work of the agency?
Yes, I do.
All right, now before all five committees is a resolution of the committees reviewing and approving internal audit staff functions. Assuming the first and second previously entered for all five committees, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion carried, resolution adopted.
Let's move to item four, resolution approving multifamily finance audit report.
Okay, here we review the requisition process, the permanent loan process, the accounting transactions, and the system of internal control as of December 31st of 2015. The multifamily financing program functions are performed by three separate groups, the multifamily group, the bond financing group, and the loan servicing group. The multifamily group pretty much reviews the applications submitted by the developer. They review the qualifications and do the underwriting, where the bond servicing group is responsible for managing the sales of bonds and notes and to provide expertise on existing bonds and special purpose bonds, and the loan servicing group performs requisition processing and converts the loans from construction to permanent process, permanent mortgage. All the financings must meet the requirements of the program, IRS codes, and any financing replacing agency bonds must have credit enhancement. Our audit included a review of the requisition processing, the permanent loan processing, the underwriting, accounting transactions, and systems of internal control. The results of our audit was we were able to satisfactorily achieve our objectives. There were two items in the report. Management has responded to those items, and we're going to ask if they accept the report and management's response.
What's the timetable? The response talks about fixing or responding to the potential for human error by implementing BAM. What's the timetable on that?
Well, the timetable generally depends on how complicated the process is. We generally try to have something resolved within 30 to 90 days, depending on how complicated or longer it involves systems enhancements. But generally, we try to have it done within 30 to 60 days.
So this is part of a larger technology project.
Were you mentioning BAM?
Yeah.
We're going to get a report on BAM, an update later on at the board meeting.
Okay.
Yeah, no, this doesn't specifically deal with the BAM.
Okay.
All right. Now before the HFA committee is a resolution of HFA reviewing and approving internal audits multifamily unit internal audit report. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the HFA committee, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Motion
aye.
Carried. Resolution adopted.
Let's move to item five, resolution approving MBBA audit report.
So here we just reviewed the accounting transactions, the system and internal controls as of March 31st of 2016. As of our audit date, there were approximately $466 million in bonds outstanding. Not much activity has happened in the program since our last audit in 2013. However, we would note that the federal government has reduced its, and I always mention this wrong, rate for bonds that are eligible for credit under the IRS code, and that has been reduced from 8.7 in 2013 to currently 6.8 in 2016. Our audit included a review of the debt service, the federal subsidies, the use of funds, certification, of course, agency fees, accounting transactions, et cetera. The result of our audit was that we were able to achieve our audit objectives. There are no items in the report, therefore management didn't have to respond to the report. So we're gonna ask you to just accept the report.
I'll jump in. Now before the MBBA committee is a resolution of the State of New York Municipal Bond Bank Agency reviewing and approving internal audits, Municipal Bond Bank Agency bond program audit report, assuming the first and second previously entered for the MBBA committee. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Way to go.
The motion is carried. The resolution is adopted. Thank you.
Way to go.
You're out of a job.
We got things to do today. There being no unfinished business, as far as I can tell, I ask for motions and seconds to adjourn each of the five agency members and directors committee meetings.
So moved.
Second.
All right, so now we're gonna go to the governance committee.
Assuming the first and second previously entered for all five committees, all in favor, please signify by saying aye. Aye. Motion to carry, the meetings are adjourned. Thank you very much. The next audit committee meetings are scheduled to meet on Thursday, January 26th. 2017. We are slipping here. Let me tell you, we are not what we were.
Well, we have a new board member for MBBA has joined us.
Thank you,
Mr. Schroeder.
Welcome, the Buffalo Controller.
Thank you,
Schroeder.
Good morning. Happy to be here. Thank you.
So now we're going to move to the governance committee meetings of HFA,
Steve.
Yep. AHC, MBBA. So Steve, you're up there, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Good morning.
Okay.
Good morning. I'm going to turn things over to Alex, who will take the requisite legal steps to formally open the governance committee meetings.
Okay. I note Alex? That Todd Sherman, representing Robert Mujica, director of the Division of the Budget, participating in the meeting via a video from DOB. Steve Weiss is at the Buffalo Regional Office, and Marge Rogatz is in Long Island at Garden City. I'm going to ask a motion and a second to call to order the December 15, 2016 Governance Committee meetings of HFA, AHC, Sunny May, MBBA, and Tobacco. Can I have a motion for HFA and AHC? And seconds?
So moved.
Seconds?
Second.
Okay, motion for Sunny May?
So moved.
So moved.
Second. Okay, and a motion for MBBA and TSFC?
So moved.
Second.
Okay, Steve Weiss is the Governance Committee Chair for HFA and AHC, and he would chair those committees. Agency Chairman Bill Thompson will chair the MBBA and TSFC meetings, and Commissioner Rubin is the Chairman for Sunny Bay, will chair that meeting. As items are presented to each committee throughout today's meetings, these motions and seconds, as you know, will be used unless specific items call for a different vote, or unless any committee member wishes to record his or her vote differently. For purposes of convenience and to make sure the meetings go smoothly, HFA AHC Committee Chair Mr. Weiss will conduct the meetings. Committee Chairman Weiss.
Okay, we've got 12 shared items. Item 1, the following minutes shall be deemed approved absent corrections from members and directors. Each of the following five meetings were held on September 15th, 2016. The 48th HFA Governance Committee Members Meeting, the 45th AHC Governance Committee Members Meeting, the 48th Sony May Governance Committee Directors Meeting, the 43rd MBBA Governance Committee Directors Meeting, and the 41st TSFC Governance Committee Members Meeting. Item 2, resolution approving commitment of funds for website upgrade. This is for Sony May, and Ms. Davis will discuss.
Excuse me, I have a little bit of laryngitis this morning, so please bear with me.
You were fine last night, but the office Christmas.
That's not true.
Thank you. Thank you for having me this morning. I am here to request your approval for funding for HCR to upgrade its website. I think since you're all familiar with our website, I doubt any of you would disagree that it's time for us to move forward with a much improved website that's both more user-friendly, more attractive, and also one that will allow for mobile accessibility. We know about 70% of folks who are looking to purchase a home and doing other research are doing it on their phones, and right now that's very difficult to do with our website. The total cost for the upgrade, the technological upgrade and website design, is approximately $214,000. Project will take between 6 to 18 months, and we are looking to split the cost between Sunny Mae and the remaining agencies. Sunny Mae is picking up the larger portion of the project because the majority of the work will be for the Sunny Mae site. So they are picking up $107,000, the five remaining agencies about $19,000. We are contracting with ITS, who will then work with another contractor who will dedicate two full-time staffers to this project. And again, it will be sort of on the backside for migrating to a new, updated, much easier to use content management system that will, among other things, allow us internally to make updates to the site much easier. Right now we've got one individual who does HTML and pretty much is responsible for everything, which can sometimes make updates more difficult than we would like. We will also have the opportunity to totally revamp the way the site looks so that, again, it's much more user-friendly, content is easier to find. We will have interactive features that we're not able to do right now. And while this is important for the entire agency, it's especially important for Sunny Mae. We are really looking to position Sunny Mae as a leader in the industry and also as a resource for any home buyer out there. And if we can make our site much more user-friendly and create real content that's valuable to folks, I think that'll go a long way. The other thing it'll allow us to do is move forward with a Sunny Mae branding campaign that we've been hesitant to go full force on because we have a site, we would not be able to send folks to our site with full confidence. And by upgrading the site, it's allowing us to move forward with some really creative marketing and a full campaign that, again, I think will really position Sunny Mae well in the future. So I'm here to ask for your approval for those funds.
I'm obviously, folks have questions, they should ask them, but I think this is much needed. What's the time frame for this stuff?
So we will, as soon as we get sign off from you folks, we will sign the letter of intent with ITS, and we expect to begin right at the beginning of the year. The first 6 months, we're going to focus predominantly on Sunny Mae. However, there are things that we have to do to the back end, to the entire site, before we can do that. But the idea is to push Sunny Mae changes first and then continue through the next, again, probably year to 18 months for the remaining upgrades. And then we will also have some staff training and have a maintenance contract with the IT company so that we will be able to continue to make upgrades and improvements and keep the content up to date.
Listen, the website needs, I don't know if anybody's ever bothered to try to look at our website, but it's really hard to use.
And it's a shame because we have great content down there, and I think it's just a matter of really making it more accessible to folks.
I think we have an obligation, actually, to the public. I mean, this is a public-facing agency, like DMV or anybody else. If the public can't use the website, we're blocking them out.
Absolutely. And right now, unfortunately, it takes multiple steps to get to a lot of information, and we can really streamline it. So if somebody is looking from anything from our agencies, not just Sunny Mae, it'll be so much more accessible to them. And again, while I talk about the Sunny Mae marketing, it'll also allow us to be more proactive in how we direct folks to the webs in our press releases and in all of our content, because we can be sure that it's not going to be a frustrating experience for them, which unfortunately it is at the moment.
And this really is an HCR project in that even though Sunny Mae is providing funding here, the other agencies will join with Sunny Mae in funding the project as a group.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, Alex, do you want to call the question?
All right, now before the Sunny May Committee is a resolution of the Governance Committee of Sunny May approving the expenditure of funds for website redesign. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for Sunny May, all in favor please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Marge, yep. Motion is carried, aye. Resolution adopted. The next item.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, item three, approval of minority and women-owned business enterprise program annual goal plan for fiscal year 2017 through 2018. This is for all five agencies, and Wanda Graham will discuss this. Good morning, Wanda.
Good morning. Joining me today is Veronica Flanders from my team.
Good morning.
I'd like to go through the goal plan for the MWBE program. As you know, the Office of Economic Opportunity is responsible for analyzing the agency's expenditures, identifying opportunity for MWBEs, working with the various departments of the agency to create procurement strategies, also identifying obstacles that the agency may face in meeting the overall goal. We also monitor and report on a quarterly basis the activity to ESD and to the executive chamber. For purposes of the MWBE activity, we've divided the agency spend into procurement, development activity, and bond-related financing. So looking at our goal plan on page two, because we now have five fiscal years of data, we thought it was good to give a historical look back of what the agency's activity has been. The executive chamber and ESD focuses on the bottom line. Our bottom line may not have always met the target, but let's look at what we did to get there. So if we flip to page three, we've not only broken out the fiscal year utilization, but we've broken out the utilization quarter by quarter. And you'll see in procurement, we've made tremendous improvements coming from 5% since the inception of this office monitoring of the program and to almost 28%, which is major in procurement. And procurement makes up 1% of the agency's spend. Most of our activity is in the development area, which I'll talk about in a minute. But also on page three, you'll notice that legal is a part of the procurement spend, and legal has done a tremendous job in having MWB participation. And
you really should tell me about this before.
I had to see your face.
I never expected that. We're always at the back end.
Achieving approximately 15% of utilization, which is great for our legal department. if we flip to page four, moving on to bond-related activities, this area has done extremely well with MWB managers and co-managers. Our data here includes remarketers, which we are backing out going forward because of the changes in the variable rate market. But looking at this half of the fiscal year, 16-17, they have achieved 24% and climbing. So we're doing a very ambitious job in bond-related activity as well. Going to page five, looking at development. Now, development is the largest area spent for the agency. We know we're a financer. And our development portfolio has been achieving close to 15% each fiscal year. We have looked at the development portfolio, which consists of finance and development and our grant program, the AHC. For AHC, we've been able to exclude areas where there's no opportunity for MWBE participation, for example, land acquisition, or where the grants are being used for down payment and closing cost assistance to the home buyer. So we've been able to carve that out. For home improvement grants, we've worked with the grantees to create pre-qualified panels inclusive of MWBE. You can't tell the homeowner who to pick to do the plumbing work in their home, but we can make those firms available to them. But you'll see in our development portfolio, like I said, we've averaged close to 15% each fiscal year, with a peak in activity in the third quarter, and we surmise that ties into the construction season. we go to page 6, what we've done, again, we are submitting this report to ESD, so we want them to get a good look at what our agency is about and how we operate. So what we did was we took our all affordable program, which does very well with MWBE utilization, and looked at the funding regionally. And then we looked at the MWBE participation within those regions. And what we surmised there is that there is MWBE participation around the state. There's one region where there has been no MWBE participation, but that says to ESD, this is where you need to go to build capacity to help us.
Which region?
That was the Mid-Hudson region.
Yeah, Mid-Hudson. It's very little compared to the amount that was funded.
Okay. So we're working with ESD, we're working with the various departments here in the agency to increase participation. We're working with the industry organizations. But I think when you look at how we get to the bottom line with procurement, with bond related, with development activity, the agency is doing a great job. And I thank my colleagues in the various departments who work with us to meet these goals. On page 7, we just take a projected look at the agency's budget in those three categories and outline what available spend is there for MWBEs. Again, these are projections. Page 7 and 8, we go into areas of exclusion. Those are contracts where there are no MWBEs currently in these areas, but as contracts expire, we continue to search the market as the MWBE population grows. For the exemption, these are contracts where there are no foreseeable MWBEs, and these are contracts under $25,000, which are not applicable to Article 15A. Okay. And then we move on to our last section, which is outreach, and we outline the things that the unit is doing, events that we attend, conferences that we attend, procurement strategies, like I said, that we put together with the various departments to meet our goal. This year, we've created a good faith effort committee to review all of the projects that are coming in that did not meet their goal, and we make recommendations to the executive team how we should deal with those projects. And I think that's it for the MWBE goal plan. Any questions?
So I guess my main question is, what does it mean? If I understand the goal, if we're setting a 30% goal, and let's just look at development activities, mm-hmm. which is $209 million, if you get to that 30% goal, and over a 5-year period, we've varied just above and below kind of 15%. So what does it mean for us to set a goal of roughly doubling our MWBE activity when that's been so constant despite our efforts over 5 years? Is it realistic? Are we mandated to set that level? I'm all for reach goals and I want to be really ambitious on this, and it's great to see the progress we're making, but I'm just curious what that really means for us to set a goal that seems kind of out of the can of what we've done for the last 5 years.
Well, first of all, it is mandated.
Okay.
Secondly, I do.
Okay. Great.
But secondly, I do agree with you. Why are we setting a goal so high? And that's the reason why this year's goal plan shows a historic picture of what we've been able to attain to support our position that 30% is not realistic.
Okay.
So I hope that helps you out.
You know, for purposes of staff, really having these goals, even though they're like in legal, it's actually good because it pushes you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So in a way, when you know a 30's there, everybody, and Wanda is very aggressive, and so we go. So I do think that, you know, it has an effect, a positive effect.
And well, because development is the largest area of spend, so we have to aim high there.
And when we miss the goal, what then? Does anything happen?
Well, it's a question of who set the goal. The goal is set by the governor.
Right.
So the one thing I will tell you is that commissioners wind up having to answer to the governor, director of operations, council particularly, who was the person who oversaw this. beginning from, you know, even from the start to get to 20 and then to 30. So there is lots of discussion and real accountability of why did you not get there? I mean, I know that for a fact, that there is that those discussions go on. I mean, this started in a lot of ways right after the governor became governor. And I was involved in the first first task force that he put together. They're serious about it. So commissioners wind up, Jamie's going to wind up having to answer the questions. Why didn't you get there?
And our goal plan, again, it breaks it out to show them. We are 1% procurement where the agency's doing it. We're financer. We're not like a lot of agencies that have direct contracts. So the fact that we are achieving 15% in our development portfolio, I think is remarkable.
I completely agree.
Okay.
I would just say maybe we as a board can support Jamie when he's on the hot seat seeking resources if this is the goal, Governor.
There's nothing that you can say that will be helpful.
Okay, fair enough.
He's going to have to stand up and explain that on his own.
Got it.
With me by his side.
Yes.
Good luck.
Mr. Chairman, if I just might ask a question, is there a comprehensive plan to get to the 30% and is there something that we could take a look at, or do we have it?
A comprehensive plan overall for the
state? How do you get to the 30%? There has to be a plan to get there, right?
Right. Well, we have a procurement strategy in procurement. We have a strategy in our bond-related area, and we're working with our development portfolio. We can certainly sit down with you and show you the strategy.
And to be honest about it, the only way that you can realistically get to 30% is those who do business with you on the development side who don't, you literally would have to bring, and it has been a discussion. You'd have to take, particularly against those who do repeat business with you, you'd have to take punitive action against in different ways. And it has been a discussion and about what can be done in that regard. I mean, even to the point that we've had a couple of major developers were involved with financings, and we've looked at them to say, your numbers weren't good, at least in the past, and we're going to start to monitor for the future. Have we gotten to that point yet? I don't think so, and it is something that really needs to occur in the near future. But that's the only way is to be able to hold those that you help to finance their projects, hold them accountable for producing numbers, if you will.
And with our good faith effort committee that we've created, we make recommendations, you know, after review from the developer's package. Either we go to the chamber asking for a waiver because they've made an effort. We make recommendations to collect liquidated damages. There's a formula in the contracts for that, and we've done that, I think, on three occasions where we've collected liquidated damages. We've also recommended, as the chairman said, repeat developers that we consider not financing that next deal.
Well, I would be very interested in taking you in on your offer of giving me some information, because I do believe that there is a way to do this. The state of Minnesota has been very successful in doing it on a major project where they set a goal of 32% MWBE and they achieved 36%. So there is a way to get there, but there has to be a comprehensive plan. And so I'd be curious to know what that is.
And we have a portfolio of projects that have met and exceeded their goals, so it does happen.
Okay, thank you.
To be honest about it, in construction, I mean, professional services may be easier to get to in some ways, but if you look at the dormitory authority in the state, they're on a construction basis, and they do, you know, serious construction projects. They're achieving, they're hitting their goals.
Okay.
You know,
and
so
they have direct contracts.
Yes.
They hold those contracts.
Yep. Thank you.
This report is
okay. I just want to acknowledge.
Yep.
I just want to acknowledge Wanda and her team. Alex, are we ready to call the question?
Okay. All right. So now before all five committees is a resolution of the governance committees. Recommending the approval of the annual updated and consolidated minority and women-owned enterprise annual goal plan for fiscal years 2017-2018, assuming the first and second previously entered for all committees. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion's a carry. Resolution adopted.
Okay, and while we have Wanda, item four, approval of service disabled veteran-owned business program annual goal plan for fiscal year 2017-2018 for all five agencies. Wanda.
Thank you. The Service Disabled Veterans Program is administered by OGS. This is the second year of the goal plan. The agency has a 6% goal on its activity. This program was signed into law on May 12, 2015 by the governor to assist service disabled veterans obtain contracting opportunities through the state. Again, my team will analyze agencies' expenditures, work with the various departments to identify and create activity. We have looked at the very limited pool of service disabled veteran firms around the state, which is just under 300 firms, and we've looked at the agency's activities and carved out areas of opportunity. And we find the financial advisors in marketing, commodities, IT, and some of our smaller development projects lend themselves to opportunity for service disabled veterans. But more importantly, what we've done is we've taken from the inception of this program development projects that have been funded, looked at where those projects are located around the state, looked at the pool of service disabled veterans to see who's available working in that state, who's located in that state, other firms that are willing to go to that area of the state, to just see that there's a narrow window in our development portfolio for service disabled veterans program. To date, the only area where we've realized some opportunity is in the bond related. We've had two firms. We've had through outreach, we've had responses and IT RFPs, so the word is getting out. We attend conferences and different industry-related events, marketing the opportunities here in our agency. So again, this is the second year for this goal plan. It's due to OGS on January 15th.
Great, thank you. Any questions?
All right, now before all five committees is a resolution of the committees recommending approval of the annual updated and consolidated service disabled veteran-owned business program annual goal plan for fiscal year 2017-2018. Assuming the first and seconds previously entered for all five committees, all in favor please signify by saying aye.
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 Motion's carried, resolution adopted.
Item five, adoption of action plan, again, for all five agencies. Alex?
And so what the committee members have is the proposed action plan for the upcoming year. I ask that the committee members review it, and if they have any suggestions, any topics that they would like us to address. The committee has spent most of its time on MWB and contracts, but we're open to any suggestions. Anyone, any committee member who has a suggestion, please email me and we'll add it to the action plan.
Very good.
Okay, so now before all five committees is a resolution of the governance committees approving an action plan subject to comment from governance committee members throughout the year. Assuming the first and seconds previously entered for all five committees, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried. Resolution adopted.
Okay, the next four items in the agenda are consent items. There will be no discussion on these items unless committee directors, members so desire. Item six, resolution approving salary ranges for senior officers for all five agencies. Alex.
Now before all five committees is a resolution of the governance committees adopting salary ranges for senior officers. Again, this is something we do every December. The maximum is not indicative of what folks are making. I always like to say
that.
Way
to qualify that. Alex,
it's good to set goals.
It's good to set goals. Assuming the first and seconds previously entered for all five committees, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion carried. Resolution adopted.
Item 7, approval of contracts with firms on the agency's newly established panel of information technology temporary staffing consultant, IT consultant firms. This is for HFA, Sony May, and AHC. Alex.
Okay. Lisa Pagnazzi is here in case anybody has any questions on the procurements. Now before HFA, Sony May, and AHC committee is a resolution of the governance committees of those agencies. Approving the entering into of contracts with firms on the agency's pre-qualified panel for IT temporary staffing consultant services. Assuming the first and seconds previously entered for HFA, Sony May, and AHC, all in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Motions are carried. Resolution adopted.
Item 8, approval of critical contracts with IT consultant firms for HFA and Sony May. Alex.
Okay, now before those HFA and Sunny May Committee is a resolution approving contracts with InfoPeople Corporation and Systems Application Information Network for Information Technology Consultants. Assuming the first and second previously entered for HFA and Sunny May, all in favor please signify by saying aye.
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 Motion is carried and the resolution is adopted.
Item 9, approval to extend the contract with Genworth Mortgage Insurance Corporation for administrative services. This is for Sony May.
And this is a long-standing carryover contract. Now before the Sony May committee is a resolution of the governance committee approving the continued retention of a contract with Genworth Mortgage Insurance Corporation for administrative services for the MIF. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for Sony May committee, all in favor please signify by saying aye. Motion
aye.
Is carried and the resolution adopted.
Item 10, the approval of Overture Technologies funding for hosting services relating to Sony May Express. Again, this is for Sony May. Alex.
Right now before the Sony May committee is a resolution of that committee approving the continued retention of the contract with Overture Technologies for hosting services. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the Sony May committee, all in favor please signify by saying aye. Motion is carried and the resolution is adopted.
The next two items on the agenda are information items. There will be no discussion on these items unless members and directors so desire. Item 11, annual review of financial advisor service contracts with firms on the agency's pre-qualified panel, and this is for HFA, Sony May, MBBA, and TSFC. Item 12, report on salary adjustment, management confidential. This is for all five agencies. There's no unfinished business. Can I have a motion?
Sorry. Yeah, I just wanted to mention that report is, again, like the other report, every year we're required under our guidelines for salaries to report increases to the mancons, and that's that report. So if there's no unfinished business, I'm going to ask for a motion and a second to adjourn the governance committee meetings. Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second?
So moved.
Motion carried. Second. The meetings are adjourned. The next governance committee meetings are scheduled to meet on Thursday, January 26, 2017.